What's going on, everybody? Today we're back with another Slay the Spire. We're gonna run the Silent one more time to see if we can get that Shiv build. Because I really want to get that going. Choose a carb to obtain. Get 6 block at 1 shift to your end. Starting out strong. Towards our Shiv fantasies. That elite's a bad idea, but the other elite's not. So that's where we are going. I have a feeling I'm blocking. No way. Just from the looks of it, it already looks like we are going to be doing a lot of defending on our way up to try and prevent us from being too low when we fight that elite. I mean, unless we have no defense cards. And we draw all our strikes, even though next turn I need all my strikes. Good thing I have all my defense. I'll take 1 damage. Neutralize, cloak and dagger. Not like it makes much of a difference what I use. Two strikes. All the strikes. I was about to say. Take 13 damage. Come on, something decent. We're rolling 12 cards. Boop, unload. All out attack. Cloak and dagger is somewhere in here. Parasite is also in here, which we don't want. We'll take an all out attack for free though. That's an easy choice. 13 damage is always really nice. Neutralize. All out attack and strike. Long as I can draw 1 damaging card, I think we will be fine. There it is. Let's see if we can get another shift card. We can't, but we will dash. We'll go this way and fight this elite. It seems more promising. We always look for a relic. There's no choice. Negate the next 2 curses you obtain. That can come in handy. Later. Eat the banana. Could have gained a relic. I didn't think that one through. Alright. Well, that is fine, actually. Did you shiv him? Wow. Oh, yeah, no. No, yeah, I had enough. Dagger throw, prepare. Starting to think we could have gone a discard deck instead. My mind's so focused on trying to get shivs. We need some strength for this build to work, at least to carry us to that third room and then beyond. We're gonna end this quickly. I don't feel like taking too much damage. I almost never use that card removal service. Oh man. I'm really looking forward to that shit build. We will upgrade a card. That is a lot of damage to everybody. Two ships. I think we do die. It's just too much damage. Take a second question mark, bag of marbles at the start of each turn, I'll apply. Man, we could do some serious damage if we got all out attack and die at the same time. So we will go ahead and upgrade him for that chance. You never know. There it is. Wow. I like that. Flying knee, it's better than a strike, and it gives energy next turn. See if we could do it again. Makes for a pretty easy couple rooms, that's for sure. And the boss won't be as easy, so go ahead and, yeah, I figured it was this guy. We did get the all-out attack, so we'll do the 21 damage. Wow, that was ridiculous. We're gonna drink our Swift Potion because we did get an extra energy. Do we have Deflect? We don't. Two damage. I can live with that. Instead of shivving this turn. I only need three. There we go. Two turns and 60 health. It's not bad. Dash. And block. Yeah. 20 damage. I think we want to block that. Don't know if he starts doing debuffs towards the end. Really hope he doesn't. Cloak and dagger, shiv, all attack. Kinda wish I didn't flying knee. Okay, so these are the times that I wish I had terror. Hey, perfect. I didn't even notice I was gonna push him to the defensive part. Also, every time he attacks, he slowly gets weighed down. Dash. Don't know if that was the best play, but I do like the idea of drawing a defensive card, like Dash, because that was kind of scary. Taking 20 damage there could have meant, you know, bad things. Very bad things. But now it's okay. Whew. Can't have that. Really? Oh, this one's gonna hurt. Just gotta push him into that. Might as well. see if we can somehow get past the armor that he's about to put on himself. He didn't. We just need 19 damage. Next turn, apparently. 13 damage. Next turn. 10. 10. Can't forget my 3. Get the shiv. Oh, wait, dash. Let's see what they have in store for us. Phantasmal Killer actually is a thing here. We can just get some more shiv cards. Gain energy at the start of each combat turn. Whenever you open a non-boss chest, obtain a curse. I do not want that eyeball. Obtain one potion, 30 gold, raise HP, obtain one card, upgrade a random card. Gain one energy at the start of each turn. I mean, we haven't ran into too many chests, and I negate the next two. One, I fight an elite pretty soon. Then an elite. Oh, this could be a horrible choice. Phantasmal Killer. Shiv's only gonna do 4 damage. I don't think we want that. Oh man, these guys are terrible to fight. Just because the amount of armor they have. Ah. Forgot we do double the damage. Hopefully, that means at some point, we can really knock him down a notch. Or just kill him. Killing him works. That next one was going to be very painful. Terror. I want to upgrade that as soon as possible. We'll take the 250. And then we can buy whatever we want with them. If you end your turn without block, gain 6 block. Whenever you obtain a curse, increase your max health by 6. Start each combat with 3 shivs in your hand. Well, if we want to do a shiv build, we can now. Oh wait, that path didn't have an elite. Locked requires 100 gold. Makes sense, I just spent like 600. Lots of thievery. Make my next turn. Crazy. I guess I dash. Yeah, I guess I dash. I'm okay with 7 damage, and double the damage next turn isn't exactly bad. Really not bad now. Man, that AoE has gotten crazy. Calculated gamble. A calculated gamble that does not exhaust. Wow, I hate this guy. And neutralize him. Start shivving the hell out of him. Cloak and dagger. More shivs. All out attack. Calculated gamble. Dash would have been perfect there, actually. Oh, now I take 5 damage and I lose a card. Whereas I could have dashed and took no damage and still did damage. I mean, it doesn't exhaust. Not really like it's hurting anyone if I do. Okay, there's a fireplace next turn. Just in case. Man, that is strong. Damage is a lot. I'd rather block all the damage. Gotta heal up and go kill that other elite. I'm only gonna heal like 20, so. Cloak and Dagger. Terror. Shiv. Strike. No! I did it the wrong way. I did it the wrong way again. I deserve this. Go away. I don't even want to see the rest of my hand, just go away. Pear. Oh, okay, cool. I mean, prepared is kind of like free, whereas the other one is not. Statistically speaking, I should be able to beat this elite without dying. Unless it's this guy. If it's this guy, I'll just die. Yeah, both his minions will. I think we fenced Tismal Killer. I'm waiting for the time that I get the power and the shivs on turn one. Because that would be really nice. I think we dagger throw, see what we can get. Terrorize him. Flying knee. We don't need block. So we go ahead and just regularly attack. And hope for all out attack. Well. See what we can get. There we go. I forgot he was vulnerable. Wow, that was easy. For each curse in your deck, start each combat with one additional strength. I don't like the idea of having curses, but that's not exactly bad. Take another Cloak and Dagger. Thread and Needle at the start of each combat, gain 5 plated armor. Also not bad. This is bad to fight him before an elite, though. And I have to be very careful in my choice stuff I use. I think we dash and Cloak and Dagger. There we go. We somehow managed to block all the damage. Plated armor. We play them all? Wow. That plated armor is really saving us this time. We tear. Dagger throw. Put a dagger throw away. So we can flying knee. All calculated. Deals 6 damage for each attack played this turn. With the shivs and everything, I think that's the right choice. Oh, how I do not like this guy. Shivs are going to do more this turn. Cloak and Dagger. And dash. We still block all the damage. If only we could be this lucky every time. Terror, Cloak and Dagger. Let's prepare. I think we get rid of this strike we just drew. And I also believe we take damage this turn. Oh man. Everything costs one anyways. In fact, some don't cost one. I'll lose 5 health this turn. I wonder. No? Okay, so. I was just wondering if, like, you know, some part of me thought I could gamble away the gamble. I was wrong. Mummified Hand. Whenever you play a power, a random card. Ooh, that'd be nice. So it's piercing well. Time to upgrade things. Time to see where we're going first. Time to upgrade things. Wait, a turn. All out attacks already upgraded. Cloak and Dagger. Two shivs. Deal 5 additional damage. Deals 8. What could this... Yes. Unless it makes 0-1. Which in that case, we've thrown everything. First and foremost. Always prepare just in case. Dagger throw to see if we got what we wanted. We did not. Exhaust though. We'll use one. Then we have Cloak and Dagger. And shiv her to death. That's 9. Oh. Forgot we cloaked and daggered. So now I need to do 23 damage. Terror him. I think we drink our blood potion. I don't want to lose that plated armor. It could come in a lot of handy later. Cloak and Dagger. Calculated gamble. Cloak and Dagger and Killer. And still block all the damage. Saving the Strength Potion for the last boss. 28 damage. 20 damage. 28 kills him. 42 really kills him. Cloak and Dagger. Oh, not this guy. Come on, card that you actually came. Cloak and Dagger. Flying me. Wow. This deck's not that bad with, oh gosh, confusion. Why? Hey! Gamble? I mean, I had other choices, but I don't see any harm in just kind of clicking wherever these days. Whew. Okay, so we're gonna block all the damage anyways. I think we make him vulnerable. So we can hopefully kill him next turn. That's free. piercing wail. Throw dagger, throw away, and cloak and dagger. If you want to know why I cloaked and daggered, it was mainly because I totally forgot that I had plated armor. Outmaneuver. I mean, why not? We heal. Because it always best to make sure we go to the boss fight with full health. Too close. Man, that had the potential to be an insane starting hand. In other words, it was garbage because I forgot to use potions again. Alright, well, we will now drink our potions. Neutralize. Oh man, I really don't want to discard any of these. It's a perfect hand. Get rid of enlightenment. Oh, and then we block whatever horrible thing he was gonna do to us. Prepare. Take away that. Accuracy. Dash is free this turn. Not bad. Not bad for not losing any health till now. I mean, come on, the guy's got 420 health. What am I supposed to do against that? Nothing. I have nothing to do. Though I'm pretty for sure. Oh, I don't know about that now. I was gonna say, I'm pretty sure we're guaranteed access into that third room. Not anymore, though. Dagger throw. Don't want to take away that. I believe we outmaneuver. Try and block as much of that damage as possible. Man, he's got some insane debuffs going on here right now. He's not really coming at us. Defensive stance. It's never cool. I don't think we get rid of our defense. Why not? We want to try and keep our plated armor on, the little three that we have. Didn't I use my enlightenment? This combat, could have swore that meant like the entire time. He's not coming after us, so we can just straight up attack. We do dash. Strike, defend. And save our piercing wail for something. Our free attack was actually awful, so it's not good. We'll use that again and dash. And hope for a better turn this next turn. Man. Why are you so mad at me? I didn't do shit. really hoping he's not gonna do like an insane amount of damage. He's gonna do an insane amount of damage. It's almost guaranteed. Oh, that's 45. We will take it down to 24. Wow. 20. There's gonna be a lot of cloak and daggers here. But we can still block it. Just wish they need to make something that like something that can like put debuffs on them, like I know, or take away their buffs, I guess would be better said. That would be nice. I believe I die here. No matter what I do. Maybe not. No, I still think I die. Ooh. Definitely gonna die very soon, unless I can do something about... I don't think I can do anything. Oh man, I didn't think this build was gonna be so bad versus this guy. I thought it was gonna go really well. I was wrong. For that, I'm sorry. But I hope y'all have a nice day. Please like the video if you like it, subscribe, and comment in the comment sections below. Oh, baby.